हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू वीक 51 समाचार मंथन लेक्चर सीरीज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद इजराइल पैलेस्टाइन इशू। द रूट ऑफ दिस इशू गोज बैक टू बीसी, यू नो 1000 BC। वी हैड अ किंग कॉल्ड एज किंग डेविड। नाउ किंग डेविड यू नो इज कॉल्ड एज प्रॉफिट और हजरत दाऊद अमंग द मुस्लिम्स, एंड हिज सन वॉज किंग सोलोमन हुज कॉल्ड एज हजरत सुलेमान अमंग द मुस्लिम्स। सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट समथिंग, लेट मी स्टार्ट विद दिस बेसिक इशू कि भाई व्हाई इस्लाम, क्रिश्चियनिटी एंड जुडिज्म, व्हाई आर दे कॉल्ड अब्राहमिकल रिलीजन? सो दे आर कॉल्ड एज अब्राहमिकल रिलीजन्स बिकॉज ऑल दीज थ्री रिलीजन्स consider that Abraham was the first, he was the first prophet, he was the first prophet. The humanity started with Abraham. All the you know present population, they are all kids of Abraham. ठीक है ना, that is why they are called as Abrahamical religions. अब basically you know according to and all these three religions, they consider one prophet to be their main prophet. For example, Judaism considers Moses to be the main prophet. Christianity considers Jesus to be the son of the God. Islam recognizes all these prophets. Moses, they call them Musa. David, they call them Daud. Solomon, they call them Suleiman. Joseph, they call Harun. So they recognize all the prophets, and they also recognize Jesus, whom they call as Isa. But for them, the last and the most important prophet is Prophet Muhammad. Okay, na? So a lot of things are similar between these religions. For example, if we talk of Islam and Judaism, both of them don't eat pork. They consider pork to be unclean. Just like in Islam, you have Sharia law. In Judaism, you have halakha law. Similarly, circumcision is a practice both in Islam and in Judaism. So, lot of the things are common in both the religions, but still there is a fight, and we will discuss the root cause behind that fight. So, moving on, 1000 BC. You know, this the area is called as Judea. So, 1000 BC. ये अगर हम बात करें तो उस टाइम पे दिस एरिया वॉज रूल्ड बाय किंग डेविड, एंड ही बिल्ड एंड हिज सन सोलोमन बिल्ड द फर्स्ट जूइश टेम्पल इन द जेरूसलम एरा, इन द जेरूसलम एरिया। आफ्टर दैट टेम्पल वॉज डिस्ट्रॉयड बाय द बेबीलोनियंस इन 600 BC, and many of the Jews they used to leave their holy land. So basically the original holy land of Jews is the present day Israel region or present day Palestine region. This is the original homeland of Jews, but then Babylonians came and 600 BC they destroyed the temple built by King Solomon. And finally, many Jews migrated to various parts of the world. Then finally, you know, this area came under the control of Romans. And Romans did not follow Christianity. Rather, they followed Roman religion. Because at that time, Christianity was not prevalent in Europe. I'm talking about somewhere close to 1 AD or 5 AD. So, Romans captured, Jerusalem and the whole area of Palestine and Israel. And then many Jews, they revolted against them, but many of them were killed, and many of them then migrated to Europe. So Romans also destroyed the second temple, which is built in the Jerusalem area, which is called as the Holy Temple, or what we call as Temple of Mount. Ab hua kya ki now that these Jew people, they migrated to Europe. But they were never accepted by Europe. They were never accepted by Europe. They were considered as second-grade citizens in the Christian Europe. you know, it was more of an apartheid kind of system where they used to live in a separate part of the city. They used to, in many places, they were not allowed to enter the government service, military service. So their condition was very, very, very bad. Finally, their condition improved when Arab Moors captured the Al-Andalusia region, which is the modern day Spain and Portugal. So when the Arab Muslim Moors captured that region, first time, you know, Jews were treated in a better way. They were started treating Jews as equal citizens. And this era, this phase of 500 years between 1100 AD to 1500 AD, when the Arab Moors rolled over Spain and Portugal, that is also called as the golden age of Jewish civilization, because Jews excelled in every field, be it politics. Many of the Virgils, or what we call as prime ministers, were Jews. Scientists, artists, you know, musicians, writers, philosophers. So you find many of them, you know, during the Moor era. And during the Moor era, because of their liberal attitude towards the Jews, many Jews from the Christian Europe migrated to the Al-Andalusia region of Spain and Portugal. Similarly, if we talk of the Crusade War, the Crusade Wars were fought between the Arabs, the Muslim Arabs, and the Christian Europe for control over the city of Jerusalem. Now, why Jerusalem is very important, we will discuss that in a later part of the lecture. It's holy to all the, you know, all the three religions. So, up Jerusalem pe jo crusade hua, to ultimately Jews were the allies of the Muslims. So, when we talk of the modern day world, when we see Jews and Muslims as fierce enemy, you know, if we go back to history, Jews and the Muslims have been traditional allies. Rather, the problem the Jews have faced throughout the civilization, you know, they faced from Christian Europe. Right? The major persecution that they have faced, they faced from Christian Europe. Right? So ultimately, then uske baad hua kya ki, you know, 400-500 years, finally, when the Arab Moors were there, they were treated better. Then again, the Christians captured Spain and Portugal. And again, they started treating them as second-grade citizens. And this situation continued till 19th century. Anti-Semitism was very stronger in the European states. And in 19th century, when the idea of nationalism gained importance among the, you know, European people because of the era of enlightenment, to hua kya ki Jews said ki bhai, we don't believe that we are Portuguese, we are Spanish, we have a very different culture. So the first person who actually talked about this whole theory, he was a person called as Theodor Herzl, and he's called as the father of Zionism. You must have heard this word a lot. He's called as father of Zionism because he is the person who started this theory that all Jews, whether you are a Romanian Jew, Russian Jew, Israel, any Jew, you are an Indian Jew, you belong to one nation, right? Like we have this movement of pan-Islamism that, you know, Islam knows no boundaries. You know, you are first Muslims and then you are Indian, Pakistani, Bangladeshi, etc. The same thing is propagated in the Zionist ideology that we are all Jews, we are all brothers, we are all kins, and we should be loyal to our brothers. And our original land is Israel, so we should go back to our, and we need a Jewish homeland. So he actually started this concept in 1893. It's called as the father of Zionism. And during that time, in Central Europe and in Russia, the Jews were facing a lot of discrimination. So therefore, ultimately, hua kya ki many of these Jews, they started migrating to Israel. ठीक है ना? तो अब ये तो हम बात करते हैं इसकी, अब हम आगे आते हैं. हम अब बात करते हैं कि फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर में क्या हुआ. फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर में यू नो देयर वाज अ फाइट बिटवीन इंग्लैंड, फ्रांस, रशिया ऑन वन हैंड एंड ऑल्सो यूएसए, एंड ऑन अदर हैंड देयर वाज जर्मनी, ऑस्ट्रियो हंगरी एंड ऑटोमन. ऑटोमन एम्पायर रूल्ड over parts of North Africa, the whole Middle East, and South Central Europe. So the Palestinian region, the modern day Palestinian region, was controlled by Ottomans from last 500 years. But since Ottomans were defeated in the World War I, therefore, Palestine came as a mandate to Britain. So in terms of that, it was a custodian of Palestine. And once it came under the control of Britain, you know, there was one declaration called as, you know, it was known as Balfour Declaration. And in that Balfour Declaration, Foreign Secretary of Britain said that we want a Jewish homeland in the modern day Palestine. So the first time you know UK gave them some kind of promise to the Jews that we will give you a homeland in Palestine. And that increased the confidence of Jews in the Europe, and they started migrating to the Palestinian region in large numbers. By that time, in Palestine region, the Arabs used to live. Majority of the Arabs were Muslims, but it had a significant Christian minority also. 10% were almost Christians. So these Jews from Europe started migrating, and in 1917, the total population, or among the total population of the whole region, 6% of them were Jews. So initially, the Arabs thought, ki chalo, theek hai yaar, bichare, these are people who are exploited in Europe. So, theek hai, aa rahe, theek hai, you know, aane do. But when the migration started at a greater number, and this started at a greater number in 1930s and 1940s. Why? Because of this man here, Adolf Hitler. He came to power in 1933, and he believed that the Jews were responsible for the defeat of Germany in World War I. And these Jews, these 3% Jews, has a lot of control over the, you know, economy of Germany, and therefore they need to be discriminated. So he brought the Nuremberg laws, which started treating Jews as second-grade citizens. It also banned, he also banned all the marriages between Jews and the other Germans, because he believed that Germans were the superior race. Finally, in 1941, he talked of final solution of the Jewish problem, in which he developed this gas called Zyklon B. And he said that I will, you know, ensure that, you know, each and every Jew in Europe would be killed. And after the final solution, the brainchild of that was Himmler. You know, many Jews were sent to the concentration camps, and many Jews died in that camp. I have experience of going to Auschwitz camp in Poland, and it's such a poor sight when you go to those gas chambers, and when you stand there, you know, you feel some kind of energy there, because you know that lakhs of people were killed in the small room. And you know, the chambers, the burning, the crematorium, it used to burn, it used to operate 24 hours a day, because so many thousands were killed every day in that Auschwitz camp. 1.5 million Jews and other people were butchered in just 3 years. You know, it was such a literally pathetic sight. You know, I could not sleep for 2 days after visiting that site, because all you can see around that area is sadness. You feel sadness there, you know. So that's actually a very bad site. And so, as you know, that if you can see this, you know, this is an example of Auschwitz camp, where they were, you know, they were made to work 16 hours a day, and they were given very limited food, treated worse than animals, you know, worse than animals, and they were kept alive only till the time that they are healthy. Once they become sick, then they were sent to the gas chambers. So, hota kya tha wahan pe ki wahan pe a train used to come filled with Jews, and then Dr. Mengele was there, and Dr. Mengele used to personally check every person. If a person is healthy, then he used to be sent to the field to work. If a person is looking sick, then directly they were told ki that now that you guys have taken such a long journey, you must be tired, so go to these bathroom and you know, shower yourself. And then they used to open the shower, or shower mein pani nahi tha, gas hoti thi, and they used to be killed. So that is how they used to ऑपरेट. नाउ हुआ क्या कि जब होलोकॉस्ट शुरू हुआ तो लॉट ऑफ ज्यूज स्टार्टेड माइग्रेटिंग टू पैलेस्टीनियंस एंड देन फाइनली द अरब्स यू नो दे काइंड ऑफ वोक अप एंड दे से कि भाई इन सम टाइम दे विल बी मेजॉरिटी इन दिस लैंड. And then, you know, there was some kind of civil war which started between the Jews and the Arabs. Jews also formed their resistant army. Finally, you know, in 1940-42 or 1943-44, when UK said, "Bhai, hum se nahi ho payega, my job was to ensure that these guys fight. Now that they are fighting, now I'm not the party to it." So UK, which had already been weakened after the World War II and Quit India movement, UK said ki bhai this matter will be resolved by UN. By that time in 45 UN was established, so the matter was sent to UN. UN finally came out with this partition plan of the Palestinian region in which the Palestinian territories will be divided into two. So you have these orange area which is Arab controlled, and you have these blue area which is Jewish controlled. So this partition plan was proposed by the UN, but the Palestinians and the Arab countries did not accept the plan. He said, "Bhai, hamari land thi. We were living there for last 2,000, 3,000 years. Now somebody comes and claims ki bhai 3,000 saal pehle hum yahan rehte the. To aisa thodi na hoga. Matlab, you know, we did not persecute Jews. The Jews were persecuted by the Christian Europe, by Hitler. So if you want the homeland for them, give them the homeland in Europe. Why are you sending it to us? Why should our land be partitioned?" So Palestinians and Arabs did not accept this proposal. But Israel unilaterally announced its independence, and thus the Israel was born, and David Ben-Gurion became its first prime minister. Now, once the state of Israel was born, then what happened was, it was attacked when the state of Israel was born. It was attacked by the Arab countries. They felt that a new state is being made. What will it be? So they attacked, but ultimately the war was inconclusive. But what happened was that West Bank ka jo area, jo eastern Jerusalem ka area, tha, wo aapka Jordan ne capture kar liya. West Bank was also captured by Europe. Jordan. Golan Height was captured by Syria. Gaza Strip was captured by Egypt. Sinai was also captured by Egypt. So in 48 war, it was an inconclusive war. But finally, Israel defended itself strongly. What happened after that was 67 May, again these Arab countries attacked Israel, and they thought this time we will finish Israel. But in next 20 years, Israel became very stronger because Israel became close ally of USA. In USA, Jews are somewhere around 1%, but they are very strong economically. All the Wall Street is run by Jews. So it became strong ally of USA. It got a lot of arms from USA. And that is how, Israel defeated the combined armies of Jordan, Syria, Egypt, and many other Arab countries. And what happened this time? Israel did not just capture the territories, it also took certain it did not just defend its own territory, it also captured the territories of Egypt, Syria and West Bank. For example, it captured this West Bank from Jordan, Golan Heights from Syria, Gaza Strip and Sinai from Egypt. ठीक है ना? So that is what happened during this period. अब हुआ क्या इसके बाद कि जब ये चीज हुई, all these things happened, तो 63-64 में एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बना PLO, Palestinian Liberation Organization, जिसके लीडर थे charismatic लीडर यासिर अराफात. And by 74 the Arab countries, it recognized, because Arab countries by that time realized, 73 mein ek aur war hua tha, but that was also inconclusive. So Arab countries realized that Israel became too powerful, and this time if we will attack Israel, they will capture some of our original territories also. So Arab countries ne kaha ke bhai, the sole representative of the Palestinian people is PLO, Palestinian Liberation Organization, and even UN accepted PLO as observer. So PLO was led by Yasser Arafat, and initially it was based on armed struggle, but in 1993 PLO stopped, or it renounced armed struggle, and it also recognized the right of Israel to exist. So PLO ka jo political wing hai, that is called as Fateh. And Fateh is a secular organization. It believes in Arab secularism, Arab nationalism. Many of its members, top members, are also, Christians and even Jews, Arab Jews. You know, if we talk of the Palestinian struggle, we should not look it from the angle of religion. After Hamas has come, yes, there has been a religion angle which has been involved, but historically, the Palestinian struggle has been more or less a secular struggle of Arab people. After Yasser Arafat, the second most tallest leader of the Palestinian movement was George Habash. And George Habash was a Palestinian Christian. Right? And George Habash, when he died, the Israeli newspaper, it actually announced this thing that the Christian godfather of the Palestinian terrorism. So he was called as the Christian godfather. So ultimately, and even now, Hanan Ashrafi was the Palestinian ambassador to UN. All of them are Christians. So ultimately, PLO was a left-wing secular organization. But then in last 15 years, the power of PLO has diminished. And the power of new organization, Hamas, emerged. We'll talk about Hamas in the later part. So, now we come to when PLO ban gaya, PLO ke baad, PLO UN mein pahunch gaya, finally, Egypt realized this thing, ki bhai, territories of Gaza and Sinai, they were lost and we need these territories back. So, at that time, Egypt was under the leadership of Anwar al-Sadat. He is Anwar al-Sadat. And Israel was under Benjamin Begin, and this is Jimmy Carter in between. So Anwar al-Sadat, he sent some priest prospects to Israel. Israel accepted that. Finally, Anwar al-Sadat traveled to Israel, and he became the first Arab leader to travel to Israel. Finally, both of them met, and finally, they signed the Camp David Accord, under which Egypt became the first Arab country to recognize Israel and to have diplomatic relations with Israel. On the other hand, Israel said, we will leave Sinai. We will not leave Gaza, but for this moment, we will leave Sinai to Egypt, and you can rule over Sinai. This was the first diplomatic arrangement between any Arab country and the Israel. Finally, in 1987, the first Intifada means uprising. The first Intifada, happened in the West Bank and the Gaza region, and in which Palestinians revolted against Israel. It continued for 6 years. Many thousand Palestinians and some hundred Israelis died during this whole process. Finally, it was ended by the Oslo Peace Accord. It was ended by the Oslo Peace Accord. Oslo Peace Accord mein, finally it was, decided that there will be peace between both the partners. So you have Yasser Arafat and you have Yitzhak Rabin, who was the left-wing moderate leader of Israel. So they both signed the pact under which PLO accepted the right of Israel to exist. PLO renounced any kind of armed struggle. In return, Israel said, we will give you certain self-governing areas. For example, this accord said that there will be
two territories. Let's see. There will be two areas, West Bank and Gaza Strip.
Palestinians will be given self-rule in those two territories, which means except defense and foreign affairs. There will be Palestinian self-rule in this area of West Bank and Gaza Strip. ठीक है ना. अब ये इसमें कहा गया और बिटवीन और इन वेस्ट बैंक ऑल्सो द टेरिटरी वॉज डिवाइडेड इन टू थ्री पार्ट. दिस इज द एरिया और दिस पैलेस्टीनियन टेरिटरी वॉज डिवाइडेड इन थ्री पार्ट. द ब्लू एरिया इज वेयर इजराइल कंट्रोल सिक्योरिटी एंड ऑल्सो गवर्नेंस. देन यू हैड द डार्क ग्रीन एरिया वेयर देर इज पैलेस्टीनियन सिविल एंड सिक्योरिटी सेल्फ रूल. सो इवन द सिक्योरिटी विल बी मेंटेन बाय द Palestinians. And then you have the light green area where the Palestinians will have the civil governance, but the security will be controlled by the Israelis. So this Oslo Accord jo tha, uske baad elections hue West Bank mein and PNA or the Palestinian Assembly came to power under the leadership of Yasser Arafat. ठीक है. अब क्या हुआ 2000 में बाय 2000 अगेन जो ओस्लो पीस अकॉर्ड्स के प्रपोजल्स थे वो ऑन ग्राउंड इंप्लीमेंट नहीं हुए एंड देयर वाज आल्सो लॉट ऑफ अनरेस्ट अमंग द पैलेस्टीनियन पीपल एंड दिस अनरेस्ट वाज आल्सो एक्सप्लॉइटेड बाय ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कॉल्ड एज हमास. सो हमास इज अ एक्सट्रीमिस्ट सुन्नी आइडियोलॉजिकल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विच बिलीव्स इन क्रिएटिंग ऑर्थोडॉक्स इस्लामिक स्टेट इन द Palestinian region. So unlike Fatah, which believes in secular Palestinian state and which is left wing in its approach, Hamas on the other hand is extremist Islamist organization which used to believe in total destruction of Israel. So Fatah believed in peaceful coexistence, but Hamas believed in total destruction of Israel. So Hamas jo tha, Hamas ne is सेकेंड इंफिताहदा को सपोर्ट भी किया एंड इन दिस द वायलेंस वॉज मोर एंड मोर नंबर ऑफ पीपल वर किल्ड. फाइनली 2005 में ये सेकेंड इंफिताहदा भी खत्म हुआ एंड उसके बाद अभी जो प्रेजेंट सिचुएशन है वो ये है कि इन 2006-07 इलेक्शंस वर कंडक्टेड इन गाजा एंड हमास केम टू पावर इन गाजा स्ट्रिप. इन द वेस्ट बैंक एरिया इट इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय Fatah, which is a political wing of PLO. And after the death of Arafat, the leadership was succeeded by Mahmoud Abbas. ठीक है. अब 2005-06 में जब हमास यहाँ पावर में आ गया तो इसराइल ने क्या किया कि इसराइल ने गाजा का पूरा ब्लॉकेट कर दिया, which means Gaza is surrounded from all sides. Gaza cannot accept aid from any other place. And Gaza it has the highest density rate in the world. The situation is pathetic in the Gaza Strip. ठीक है ना. अब हम आते हैं अगले इशू पे, which is the issue of settlement. So हुआ क्या कि Yitzhak Rabin, who signed peace accord with Yasser Arafat in 93, he was assassinated by a Israeli extremist in 1985. And after that, the power in Israel is mostly dominated by Likud party. It's a right-wing party led by Benjamin Netanyahu. Netanyahu is very nationalist, right-wing. Some people call him far-right. So Israelis started this settlement process from 1990s. What is settlement? So if you see this map here, you will see three type of areas. So you will see the dark brown areas where the Palestinians have full control. Then you have the other areas, and third area you can see these dots, these blue dots. These are the areas of Israeli settlement. So, ab jab ye Oslo Accord mein bola gaya tha ki bhai West Bank aur Gaza mein aapko full autonomy milegi, but usko violate karke Israel kya kar raha hai? Israel is settling Israelis or Jewish people in the West Bank area and to some extent even in the Gaza area, but it knows that they will be fierce. Aggressive reaction from the Arab side. So what they are doing is they are doing a fencing. इस तरफ से वो fencing कर रहा है, road से fencing होती है, and on one side जो सबसे fertile land होती है, वहाँ पे Jews रहते हैं, On the other side, you have the Arab people who are living, and the situation of Arab side is very bad. You don't have paved roads, you don't have, you know, good sewage network, etc. In the Jewish side, everything is well maintained. And road se kya hota hai? Road se Jews ka settlement hota hai, uske liye cut hota hai. And wahan pe sirf Jews hi ja sakte hai, the Arabs cannot go there. So it's kind of a modern day apartheid system which is being run in the West Bank region. So this settlement issue has been declared as illegal by UN. And even India has said, you know, this is not right because this goes against the spirit of the, you know, Oslo Accord. But Israel has been doing that from last 25 to 30 years. Similarly, now let's come to the cause of the current clash. So if you talk of the current clash, the cause of the current clash, you know, there is an area. So abhi dekho, what is the modern day scenario? Modern day scenario is that the capital of Israel is Tel Aviv and the capital of Palestine is Ramallah. ठीक है, अब problem ये है कि Jerusalem की पूरी fight है. Jerusalem is considered as holy city by all the three major religions, Islam, Christianity and Judaism. Why it is considered as holy for Judaism? Because as I've told you, the first temple was built by, or the first temple was built in the old city of Jerusalem. This area, jo main aapko show kar raha hun, somewhere here, which is the Temple Mount. Ye thoda sa hilly area hai. Temple Mount pe, first temple and the second temple, or second Jewish temple were built, which were destroyed by Babylonians and the Romans. Chikep. So for the Jews, it is the holiest city in the world. It is from here that, you know, Judaism originated. For Islam, it is the third most holiest city after, or it is the, this Al-Aqsa Mosque here. It is the third, sorry, no, this is Dome of Rock. This is Al-Aqsa Mosque. The Al-Aqsa Mosque is the third most holiest city for Islam after Mecca and Medina. According to the Islamic mythology, Prophet Muhammad went to heaven from the Al-Aqsa Mosque and he lived a lot of his life in Jerusalem. ठीक है. Similarly, for Christians, Jerusalem is very important because Bethlehem, which is the place where Jesus was born, it's on the outskirts of Jerusalem, and also in Jerusalem, Jesus propagated his ideas, and he was also crucified in you know, Jerusalem, and he was buried in that, and in that area there is a church. So for both these three religions, Jerusalem, especially this whole complex, is very holy. ठीक है, तो Israel has always claimed that Jerusalem is its capital, but foreign nations have not recognized that, and they have their embassies in Tel Aviv. Also, Palestinians have laid claim over Jerusalem. Abhi kuch saal pehle, USA has said ki, you know, USA has recognized Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, which means now US embassy will be situated in Jerusalem and not in Tel Aviv. ठीक है ना? तो अभी recently क्या हुआ कि एक area है Jerusalem में Sheikh Jarrah. तो शेख जर्रा से, यू नो, मेनी ऑफ देयर लोकल पैलेस्टीनियन, शेख जर्रा इज डोमिनेटेड बाय द पैलेस्टीनियन अरब्स. तो शेख जर्रा में क्या हुआ कि सम ऑफ द पैलेस्टीनियन पीपल वर इवेक्टेड बाय द इजरायली पुलिस, एंड दे वर इवेक्टेड बिकॉज यू नो इंस्टेड ऑफ देम द ज्यूइश सेटलर्स हैड टू लिव देयर. सो दैट लेड टू प्रोटेस्ट अमंग द Palestinians, and that protest became little violent when hua kya ki Al-Aqsa Mosque mein, when the Muslims were praying, the Israeli army and police stormed the mosque and almost 300 Palestinian people were injured in that. Theek hai, ab hua kya in response, Gaza. So Gaza is led by Hamas, and वेस्ट बैंक इज लेड बाय फतह. तो इन रिस्पॉन्स गाजा से हमास ने रॉकेट फेंकना स्टार्ट किया इसराइल ने. बट इसराइल हैज आयरन डोम सिस्टम व्हिच मींस कि कुछ ज्यादा यू नो डैमेज हुआ नहीं इसराइल को. बट इन रिटर्न क्या हुआ कि इन रिटर्न इसराइल ने काफी ज्यादा बॉम्बार्डमेंट किया गाजा का. सम 300 पीपल वर किल्ड इन दैट. मेनी हॉस्पिटल्स वर डिस्ट्रॉयड. मेनी किड्स वर किल्ड. यू कैन सी फ्रॉम द फोटो हाउ दे हैव अटैक गाजा. तो काफी ज्यादा जो है वो रहा. लेकिन अभी न्यूज ये आ रही है कि कल जो है इसराइल ने बोल दिया है कि नाउ वी आर रेडी फॉर सीज फायर. वी आर स्टॉपिंग ऑल द एग्रेसिव एक्शन विच इज अ गुड न्यूज. सो व्हाट हैज बीन द रोल ऑफ यूएसए इन दीज क्लैशेस. सो इफ यू टॉक ऑफ द रोल ऑफ यूएसए, यूएसए हैज ट्रेडिशनली सपोर्टेड यू नो इसराइल. एंड अंडर यू नो ट्रंप द सपोर्ट वॉज इवन यू नो मोर ओवर्ड. But when Biden came to power, now, you know, the official statement of USA is, ki bhai, you know, Israel has a right to self-defense because it was getting rockets from Hamas. So it had to respond. But it also, and also USA has blocked any discussion of this issue in UNSC. Even the 14 out of 15 members were in favor of, you know, discussion. So ab USA वैसे तो चुप है इस मामले में क्योंकि USA believes now I want to focus on you know China and I want to focus on Indo-Pacific. I don't want to focus on this small area or this troublesome Middle East region. ठीक है. अब regional powers की हम बात करें तो अभी recently Bahrain and UAE has and also Morocco they have established a diplomatic relationship with Israel. So as you know that for many of these Muslim countries. Iran, they believe Iran is a bigger threat. So they believe that Israel can keep Iran under check. So therefore, even though they protested against this onslaught, and they have protested because, you know, they want to also silence their domestic constituents. But as you know, in the modern day world, everything is about economics and commerce. And these Arab countries believe that from Israel, they will be getting technologies, they will be getting a lot of investment. So therefore, even though they have criticized the Israeli action, but बहुत mild था criticism. Only Turkey and Iran का जो था criticism वो काफी ज्यादा strong था. ठीक है. Similarly, Russia is also talking with Israel and Hamas. If you talk of India, India had took a very balanced stand. So traditionally, India has always supported the Palestinian cause from right from Mahatma Gandhi to Jawaharlal Nehru, they all have supported the Palestinian cause. But India established diplomatic relationship in 1992. But in last few years, we have gone for de-hyphenation, which means that we are treating Israel and Palestine as a different entity. Now we are not talking to them as a combine. So it means that we are talking to Israel as a different partner, and along with that, we are also you know talking with Palestine. तो इंडिया की अगर हम बात करें, इंडिया हैज यू नो गिवन अ वेरी बैलेंस्ड स्टेटमेंट दैट यू नो वी आर सपोर्टिव ऑफ द पैलेस्टीनियन स्टैंड दैट देयर शुड बी अ टू नेशन सॉल्यूशन विद ईस्टर्न जेरुसलम बीइंग द कैपिटल ऑफ पैलेस्टीन. ऑल्सो इंडिया सेड कि जो यू नो जो अलक्सा में हुआ दैट वॉज अनवॉरेंटेड. बट इंडिया ऑल्सो सपोर्टेड इसराइल राइट टू सेल्फ डिफेंस. And it did not criticize Israel's action in Gaza. So we took a very balanced stand in that. ठीक है ना? अब what is the way forward of this issue? So if you talk of way forward, there are two main way forward. पहला तो ये है कि there is a need for leadership change because Benjamin Netanyahu, जब भी you know he is politically weak, just like another leader somewhere in South Asia. I will not disclose the name. So just like him, he believes कि अगर tension बना रहेगा Palestine के साथ तो my approval rating will be high. So unless and until you remove him with a new moderate leader, this thing will go on. Similarly, you know, if there would be a successful negotiation of USA and Iran nuclear deal, that will also be good because ultimately Iran is also a big funder to Hamas.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Civil's Daily.